Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And finally, here's the review of this guy, which is the new MacBook Pro 16 Indian model. And I was waiting for doing the review, as you already like have commented many times that I should review this unit, but I was actually playing with it. It's been now 2 weeks, and I think now I'm in a good position to talk about it and to give my pros and cons about this MacBook. And this is going to be a developer centric review, so keep watching. I'm alone, I'm a broken home. I gave you all the bricks that I own and know. I'm letting go, I'm breaking these walls down, breaking these walls down. If you want adventure, then fly to home. But if you wanna travel, then go alone. Yeah, what's the point in us if I never know? If you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go. I'm tired of the pain. Go away. I'm tired of the pain. So now guys, you might be knowing that I used to have the 2018 model, which got dead. During this lockdown, and I had no option but to buy this one, which is the 16-inch MacBook Pro, 16-inch one. So this is the MacBook Pro which I could buy, and it has 1 terabyte of storage as well as 16 gigabytes of RAM. Although I wanted to buy the 32 gigabytes of RAM, but then we had no option in India to buy that one. So yeah, I ended up buying this. And second thing is, like, I could wait for some time, but you know, I didn't wanted my work to, you know, somehow suffer because of this. So that's why I bought it. And I think that laptop, I have like Apple Care Plus as well, so it will be fixed any day. One service center will be opened, so I'll maybe I can sell it, and I don't know what I'll do with that. But now, coming back to this MacBook Pro, I'll talk about all the things which I liked about this MacBook and all the things which I didn't like about this MacBook. So first thing, let's talk about the pros or the things which I really liked about this MacBook. So first thing I want to talk about here is the keyboard. Damn! And guys, like, I had that 2018 model. It had butterfly keyboard, and that is really pathetic. Like, you used to press just one key, let's say space bar, and it used to give many spaces because I don't know what kind of thing was happening with that, but it is really, really bad for someone who writes a lot of things, someone who's a developer, someone who, like, for everyone, I think, because what is the most important thing when you buy a laptop is keyboard, right? You cannot replace it as well. So it's very difficult, and that's the thing with the MacBook, like the previous generation, because butterfly, it was definitely not good. And now they have this Magic Keyboard, which is pretty much similar to what they used to have. The 2015 model was having the same thing, and that was really good. That was one of the best laptops, I think, from Mac or from Apple. And this one is definitely very good in terms of keyboard. I had a really good experience with the keyboard. Second thing which I liked about this MacBook is definitely its speaker as well as the microphone. So the speakers are really amazing. I don't think I need any external speaker or any Bluetooth speaker to listen to songs. This works really amazing. And the microphone also has been improved for most of the times. Like, let's say if you are doing a Zoom call, or if you're talking to friends on FaceTime and all, you don't really need this extra microphone. I use this extra microphone only for making these videos, otherwise I don't use it. This internal microphone is really good. The third thing which I liked about this MacBook is its display. They have increased the size of the display. It's now 16-inch, so they had to minimize that particular part of wider section of the display. They have make it more wider, which is good. But the most important thing is that color accuracy has been improved. So I am someone who is doing some UI stuff as well, like user interface, and I'm making them, as well as I do some video editing as well. And apart from that, I am someone who changes their like his theme frequently. Like even if I'm development, like I'm doing development, then also I'm like, you know, changing themes regularly in VS Code and all those things. So I really see those colors, and I have seen like this MacBook definitely is better than my last one in terms of color accuracy and all those things. And it is more sharper as well. That's what I have observed. I think resolution has been changed because of the screen size. But yes, overall, it's the display is really good. So third thing is definitely the display, which they have improved. The fourth thing is overall performance, and this is the most important part. So basically, I think most of the time when I'm using Android Studio, VS Code, Xcode, and Chrome, these four things together, then my previous generation MacBook was going to like, you know, like increase the fan speed a lot. Which is not the case here, like it's not that much as compared to that. And I'm gonna give you a good trick as well. So the fan speed is kind of normal. The CPU temperature remains better than the earlier one. So it's around 60 degree, 65 degree, not more than that. For my last MacBook, it used to cross sometimes 90 degree and even 100. So that was very bad. But this looks fine. There are some like, you know, some issues with external keyboards. Sorry, external monitors, not keyboards. External monitors, if you're using, then there can be some issues. But those are not a MacBook related issue. Those are probably because of how these Intel chips are doing, like behaving. Like, you are like expending a lot of money for this, so you believe that, you know, you should get the best laptop for that price. But I think there are some issues, but there's a trick how you can fix them. This can be definitely fixed by adjusting the fan speed, but that's not something which you will be like able to do. But if you are buying this 1 TB model, which is coming with the i9 processor with 8 cores, not 6 cores, then what you can do, you can disable your turbo boost, and it definitely helps in, you know, avoiding those things. And yeah, so performance has been improved a lot. The fans are behaving better. The overall, I think CPU thing is very good as compared to last generation. So that was the fourth thing which I liked about it. The fifth thing is definitely the battery backup. It's really good. Like I think I can, like, whenever I'm using like all these things like Xcode, Android Studio, VS Code, then also I can definitely spend like 4 hours without charging it again. So 4 hours is a really good backup, because with my last generation MacBook, it was hardly 3 hours or something when I'm like doing heavy task or something which is actually doing a lot of processing and all that stuff. So battery backup has been improved a lot, and overall it's a good laptop, and I think all these pros makes it a perfect laptop. So now let's talk about some cons, because it's not possible with MacBooks that they don't have any cons. So the first con which I want to talk about is definitely the issues with the software, and I don't know, it can be a hardware issue as well. That's why you might have heard that, you know, Apple is now experimenting with AMD chips as well. But I think that does not bother any consumer, because for as a consumer, what I would want, like I'm expending this much money, it's really expensive, and still I'm not getting the best laptop. So that's really something which I care about a lot. And I think in performance, like I have faced some issue, like sometimes it used to get freezed, the cursor is like freeze sometimes, and that happens with a lot of people. I have read it on Reddit as well as some other blogs. So that is something which is happening, and the reason which I could find out was the automatic graphic switching. And once I disabled it, it was kind of working fine for me, but I still don't know if that was the exact issue, and maybe it can be fixed with a software update. But yeah, I think those issues really affects the user and the user experience, so that should be fixed for sure. The second thing which I did not like about this MacBook is its camera. I mean, you know, we are in 2020, and even Dell has or Dell not Dell I think Surface Book 3 has now 1080p camera. They have improved the microphone, which, you know, it's easy to buy a microphone or use it like with this MacBook or any MacBook or any laptop. But cameras are like, you know, expensive to buy, as well as it's not easy to, you know, plug the camera and do all this stuff. So I think they must have improved the camera first and then the microphone. It's really good thing that they improved the microphone, but like, you know, you could improve the camera as well. This is the era of doing, you know, video calling and like talk, like doing meeting and all. Although it came before coronavirus, but still I feel that that is really something which should be there when you are paying this much high amount. So that was the second thing which I did not like. Third thing which I did not like about this laptop is that it's also not upgradable, which means you cannot upgrade the SSD, you cannot upgrade the RAM. I mean, that's something really sucks because, you know, I'm paying this much money and I know this is a really good laptop, but still, if I want to upgrade it, I cannot do that. And that means that, you know, Apple want you to buy another laptop maybe next year or next to next year, but actually as a laptop it can go for like next 5 years, to be honest. But because of these restrictions, it really feels bad. So that is the third thing which I definitely never liked about the MacBooks, that, like, not never, but these since they started using those Thunderbolt ports and T2 chip, everything is just getting more and more, like, you know, somehow they are restricting a lot of things. Fourth thing I didn't like about this laptop is that it should definitely come with a dongle. They are still having these four USB-C ports, but I think there is no good dongle in the market. Although I have bought one Anker one, which is really good, but I have seen many people struggling with that. So when you are like selling this MacBook for this much expensive price, just take maybe $10 more and give us a better dongle at least, which we can rely on, which can have some warranty and which can be officially from Apple. So that will be really a good addition for this. So that's definitely something which I really want to happen. The last thing is, maybe I think they should also allow other laptop manufacturer to have Mac OS, because this should not be the restriction, at least in this era, that I can only buy MacBook Pro because I have to use Xcode, I have to use Final Cut Pro, and I don't have any other option. Like, rather than just buying MacBook, I could buy a cheap Windows laptop or maybe any laptop with good configuration which could support Mac OS, but it's not the case. It is not going to happen. Although I know that, but still I think, you know, just being optimistic that it should happen. And apart from that, like, what I didn't like about this laptop as a whole is that it's very expensive, but still some of the shortcomings are the same which were from, you know, last few generation. They have finally fixed the keyboard. That is the most important thing. Apart from that, it's the kind of the same thing. But yes, overall developer experience is good, like development is really good on these machines. But there is something which I really want to share with you, that in India or these countries where, you know, technology is booming, everything is happening good, but still these are not customizable. Like in India, you cannot customize these MacBooks, which you can still do in other countries. And they are not even selling the 32 gigabytes model in India. I have heard that this will happen soon, but yeah, it's not happening right now, right? That's really bad. And you are not even selling Apple Care Plus in India. Why is that? Like, you are selling it in US but not in India, because what is the thing? Like, can't we, like, you know, make it bad somehow? We can, like, we can also have some issues with the laptop. We would want to have some kind of insurance or something similar to Apple Care Plus, but I don't know why they are not doing it in India. I would definitely love to see that in future. But yeah, these are some of the things. Now, who should buy this laptop and who should not? So first thing, if you are definitely someone who has sufficient money to invest in MacBooks, then only you will buy it. Second thing, if you work with the Xcode, if you use Final Cut Pro, if you use GarageBand, then only you will buy it. And if you are someone who does not match these two things, then you should definitely go for a Windows laptop. Or you should, if you don't want portability, then it's really good if you can, like, assemble your own PC with a very, very lesser cost than this, and it will do wonders for you. It will be upgradable, it will have all things which you would want. with a great GPU and everything. So overall, this is good, but not the best, not the perfect. But yeah, I think I didn't have any option, so I had to buy it. But overall, I think the app development experience been good. As a developer, I have been like using VS Code, Android Studio, IntelliJ, Xcode, as well as I have been using Camtasia for editing, Final Cut Pro. All of these are working fine. I have tried to use them simultaneously. At maximum, I have opened like 15 tabs in Chrome as well. Mostly I am using Brave browser as well. But I think Safari, if you are using Safari, then it can be really great experience, because Safari is much more optimized in that way. So the two tricks which I want to tell you before I end this video is that try to turn off the turbo boost and see if that helps you in like, you know, it will not run your fans that fast, as well as it will reduce the CPU temperature. Second thing is that if you want to like change the graphic status, like if it is using external GPU or not, then also you can see how it works. And similarly, like you can adjust the CPU fans as well to check like what suits like your situation, your condition. Because in India, if you are in 45 degree Celsius temperature, then you really need an AC, or you should like, you know, adjust these things at least. So that's it about this video. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Please like this video if you got something out of it, and also subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon to get future updates. I'll see you in the next video. Please let me know in the comments what's your thoughts about this MacBook, and if you have any question, then also you can ask me in the comments. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye, take care and have fun.
Is circuit terko nahi pata hai mereko kitna problem ho raha hai is MacBook se yaar. Ye MacBook nahi yaar, aafat ki pudi hai. बोले तो उनको तो दूसरा लैपटॉप चाहिए मामू।